Okay, so one of the topics for today is talking about jaw pain, or TMJ. So TMJ stands for temporomandibular joint. So that's the jaw joint. Talking, eating, all those things create repetition or exercise for that joint. Some of us run into trouble. We'll see clients refer directly from dentists with complaints of pain, grinding at night, so that's called bruxism. Someone can end up with a locked jaw, meaning all of a sudden, for unknown reasons, they cannot open their mouth. So just like the shoulder and things like that, your TMJ joint has different shapes. So some of us, instead of having a deep socket, we have a shallow socket, which means when we open our jaw, there may be more travel of that jaw bone or that mandible bone. So you've got your mandible, which is your lower jaw joint, and it goes up. You also have a disc in there. It's attached to muscles, in particular, this muscle. So this is your lateral pterygoid muscle. That lateral pterygoid muscle is one of the muscles that we're actually going to get to through going into your mouth. I will say, if this muscle is a problem for you, you won't like it when we poke on it. It's tender more than any other muscle. Otherwise, other muscles that will contribute, or we will assess and possibly include in treatment, both in the clinic, so releasing those muscles, or teaching you at home how to release them yourself, will be things like temporalis. So that's the muscle that goes from your zygomatic arch, or this bony arch at the top of your cheek. It kind of hooks there and goes up like a big fan to the side of your head. Then you've got your masseter muscle. So it goes from that zygomatic arch and goes down and hooks underneath of your jaw. And so masseter, of course, by the looks of it, its job is to close your mouth and chew. So for masseter, I'll tell you, poke, find that knot. Now keep that pressure while you open your mouth. And then close, and then press, open, press, open. You do that about 10 times for every sore muscle. Same with here, press, open. And sometimes that release is one way to help. Now the pterygoid muscle, the way to get in at it best is I like to tell my clients to use the opposite hand. Wash your hands before you do this, of course. But you're gonna use your thumb. So the hand, so I'm using my left hand to get into my right lateral pterygoid. I'm gonna take my thumb and I'm essentially gonna go into my mouth in a second on the outside of my teeth and run that thumb as far back, keeping my nail bed against my lower jaw. And what I'm gonna do with my other fingers, I'm literally gonna pinch my cheek. And we're just gonna pinch and rub in circular motions. So there's that static rubbing, just to test it out, how's it doing? And then we're gonna do a release. So, thumb going inside mouth, pull back. So I'm basically at the back of my cheek right now. If I push out, you can see that little bulge right here. So I'm gonna pinch with my fingers and just rub. And then if I wanna release it, I'm gonna pinch and open. Oh, that's tender. Let me wash my hands. So the lateral pterygoid muscle is a tender one. It takes getting used to. Not everybody can massage it right off the bat. It's something you have to work your way into, but fear not. If you're having any jaw problems, let us know, we can help. Some of us, if we have something really tight on my left side, as I open, my jaw will actually shift over to that left-hand side because the muscles are so tight. But the one thing, if you want to test yourself to find out, oh my gosh, what do? I have some tightness? You can poke around on those muscles, see if you find one that's tender more than another. And the other thing that we look for, now again, this is the mirror, and you need to take a ruler and draw a straight line down. You're gonna open your mouth as wide as you can. So you'll do a couple times opening normally, and then you're gonna open really wide. And what you're watching is, where does the middle of my top teeth line up relative to the middle of my bottom teeth? Do they stay in line over my mirror, or does my lower jaw shift? And which way does it shift? In clinic, we measure how much, but for you at home, just stand in front of the mirror, stand with good posture. So if I open and close, and if I open again really wide and close, I tend to sometimes deviate. I get some tension and my lower jaw drifts. And so my homework is to try and, in front of a mirror, correct that habit. So that's kind of a bit of the TMJ in a nutshell for some of you that are having trouble. But to be honest, pick up the phone, give us a call. It's much easier for us to figure out your personal habits and changes that need to happen to make sure that you don't have to live with that issue.